China's air pollution has been making global headlines for decades, but the past year has been so bad that people are calling it Airmageddon or Airpocalypse.
Shanghai air is still far from pristine, but it's been easier to watch the pollution story from here as the rainy weather has kept the city relatively cleaner. But that's changing.
Shanghai is suffering its dirtiest winter ever. Last month, the index measuring small airborne particles, or PM2.5, a key gauge of air quality, shot up to hazardous levels. Thick smog has become the new normal. This comes as the notoriously smoggy capital Beijing is having a cleaner winter, resulting in a conspiracy theory by some expats that electricity production has been boosted in the south and cut back in the north to create a healthier environment for China's leadership. A Reuters analysis of steel, cement, and other metals production showed a drop in activity in the province around Beijing, but a pickup in areas around Shanghai in late 2013. But the main pollution culprit in Shanghai and the rest of China isn't factories or power stations, says Zhang Guoxun, director of the Center of Atmospheric Chemistry at Fudan University. It's cars.
If we don't take emergency action, the smog will get worse. I can predict it. 10 years ago, I told the Shanghai government they should limit the number of vehicles, but nowhere in China did that happen. Instead, we focused on development and it damaged the environment.
Even with pollution off the charts and the public outcry rising, officials seem reluctant to confront the problem. In Shanghai, the environmental authority last month weakened its air pollution standard to reduce the number of health alerts. Meanwhile, the central government has drawn mockery for recently classifying smog as a natural disaster. But when it's been severe enough to hamper air traffic, even some officials have to be wondering whether pollution could suffocate Shanghai's ambitions of becoming a global financial center.